Welcome to the first of a series of tutorials designed to provide you with an overview of the Queensland Globe and enable you to use it with confidence. The Queensland Globe is an online interactive tool that turns physical, geographical, and spatial data about a particular location into map format. Use the globe to access hundreds of spatial data layers about Queensland. The learning outcomes from this tutorial are an overview of features and functions, getting to know the Queensland Globe interface. The Queensland Globe is a web-based application, accessed via the following URL. This tutorial will demonstrate the desktop version of the Queensland Globe. After entering the URL in a browser of your choice, the welcome page will appear. Information about the application will display, and you will be prompted to read and agree to the terms and conditions of use. For those who are familiar with the application, select Get Started. If you are new to the Queensland Globe, you can familiarise yourself with the layout of the application through the Take Tour option. More detailed assistance is available through the Help section. Help includes answers to frequently asked questions, a catalogue of all the available data layers, and information on the latest updates. This section also provides tutorial videos and contact information for inquiries and feedback. If you wish to save and share work you create within the Queensland Globe, you will need to sign in. The top right of the screen displays an option to log in or sign up. There are a range of account options that you can choose from. Let's have a closer look at how we can control the view of the map. To zoom in or zoom out, you can use the scroll wheel on your mouse. Alternatively, you can use the zoom in or zoom out buttons. Holding the shift key allows you to make a rectangular selection, which the map view will zoom to. To pan around the map, press your left mouse button and move the map to where you want it. If you use your right mouse button, you can rotate the map away from its default north-south orientation. To return to its original orientation, press the Reset Orientation button. If your device has a positioning feature such as GPS, the Current Location button will show you where you are located on the map. By default, the map view is set to a two-dimensional viewing mode. We can change it to 3D mode and also 360 mode to view data above and below the ground. The bottom left of the interface displays key information for the Queensland Globe. Based on the active layers, details of the copyright, map scale selector, and the ability to toggle between coordinate systems is displayed. Move back and forward through your map views using the previous and next extent arrows. Now let's have a closer look at the Queensland Globe interface. The Topics section displays predefined groupings of data layers. It is a convenient way to populate the map with a theme of information and quickly add data layers. The Search section provides options to search and locate features stored within the Queensland Globe. If required, you can save the results from your search for future use. We then have Layers. Layers gives you the most control over what information appears in the map and allows you to add, remove, or filter data layers. You can adjust the visibility of individual layers and labels, or click Metadata to get more information about a data layer. The Add My Data feature will let you bring in your own data, georeference your own images, or access data through a web map service. Places provides an area where you can create and store your custom map objects. These may be objects derived from existing map layers, like search results. Or they could be objects that you have created using the drawing or coordinate tools. Places that you create can be used in a number of ways. You can label them, use them to query other data layers, and also access Google Street View. Once you have logged into Queensland Globe, you can use maps. Saving your work as a map will ensure that the data layers, map extent, and any custom map objects you've created in Places will be saved and available in future sessions. As we click on the down arrow of your saved map, there are options to take your map offline or share it with others. The print section will open a new browser window with numerous options like page orientation, size, and map scale. You can name your map, adjust the extent of the map window, display the legend, and choose to export and share your map in PDF or PNG format. The past imagery tool allows you to search and view images over your area of interest. Navigate the imagery time slider to view images and image footprints over time. Moving up the right side of the interface, we find an arrow that will reveal or hide the map legend. This legend is dynamic and will display the data layers that are currently visible in your map window. Clicking on the toolbar reveals a series of important tools within the Queensland Globe. Identify is a useful tool that allows you to click on data layers within your map window to access further information about features or a location. As you click to expand this tool, a number of options are available to help you refine your selection. The measurement tool allows you to measure distances and areas within your map window. You can also set the measurement unit. If you wish to plot a specific point, you can use the coordinate tool. Draw Places gives you the ability to create custom map objects within your map window. As you click to expand this tool, a number of drawing options are available. You can also set the style, color, and size of your drawings to your preference. Finally, you can reset your Queensland Globe session to return to the original view. We hope you have enjoyed this tutorial on the Queensland Globe. If you need further assistance, please have a look at the other tutorials in this series, check the in-depth guide on our help page, or email Open Data.